Hey everyone, some people say that you should change your case fans every 5 or 6 years. I didn't get that memo. I recently realised that my PC build still has case fans in it from 2010. Whoops. Another fan was from 2011, two were from 2012, and another was from 2015. It came with my 9-year-old Corsair Carbide 88R case. Now, I had no real issues with my computer's cooling performance, which begs the question, is there a natural point in time where you must say, okay, this fan is just too old, let's just replace it? If not, then why did I just replace all five of these fans with newer Arctic P12s? And finally, why did I rip one fin off each of these fans? Well, actually I did this because of some highly scientific testing I performed for this video. But let's take a look at all of these questions. So as we all know, PC case fans, or chassis fans as some people call them, have a simple function: they cool down the computer. Some case fans will bring new air into the case, acting as an intake fan, and other fans will expel warmer air out of the case, and we call these exhaust fans. Now, case fans can be powered in a few different ways. They can be plugged into old-school 3-pin or Molex adapters that sometimes, but not always, means that the fan then constantly runs at 100% speed, which isn't always ideal because this is noisy, of course. But this can also make the fans actually wear out faster, which is an important point that I'll circle back to a little later on. The other way of powering fans is through a 4-pin connector, the resulting variable fan speed, and this is known as PWM, which is pulse width modulation. This video isn't a primer on fan basics, so I won't cover this point much more in this video, but the key point here is that running your fans at variable speeds, so sometimes they'll be faster, sometimes they'll be slower, will increase the lifespan. That's actually what I did with my 5 old case fans. I had them running through an old Fantex fan controller, and it was rare that they ran at 100% speeds. Plus, I don't keep this computer on 24/7, it's probably on for an average of 4 hours a day, I guess. That's probably partly why these fans are still actually working fine after 14 years, in some cases. Well, I say that they're working fine, but how do I actually know this? I mean, they don't work well anymore since I totally removed all their fins. But this was all part of some ultra-scientific testing to work out whether case fans in general can still work fine after a decade or more. So the first idea I had here was to attempt the bag test. This is where you wrap a plastic bag around your case fans and make sure that it's directing new air inward. As long as there's a proper seal around all parts of the fan, in theory you can keep track of how long the bag actually takes to fill up, and then use this to work out whether the fan is still in good working order or not. The problem here is that it's actually quite difficult, as you can see, to get a good proper seal around the fan, especially when you're using cheap carry bags like I was. To be honest, you could tell though that the fans were in good enough condition just by looking at them. They were spinning fine and they weren't making loads of weird noises. So I called off my ultra scientific test and I went on to test number 2, and this was actually pretty cool. You know how case fans have an advertised RPM? This is naturally the number of rotations or revolutions that the fan will make every single minute. So I got my main Sony camera that I'm filming on right now, and I switched it to record in 120fps. I also knew that I wasn't going to be using these old case fans anymore in the future for reasons that I'll explain later on. So I removed one fin from each of these. Sorry, I'm just so sorry. Look at it, I'm a monster. I then put this footage on my computer, and I counted how many times each fan actually rotated every single second. Yes, I went through frame by frame and counted the number of times that the fan made a full rotation.
4. 5. This is scintillating.
I tracked this for a few different seconds for each fan, which then allowed me to work out the RPMs, as you can see on screen now. So the two Sharkoon fans ran at around the same speeds, getting approximately 12 to 13 rotations per second, giving an RPM range between 700 and 800 RPM. The Corsair one ran faster at around 19 or so rotations, and then the older Arctic F12 fans actually ran at 23 to 24 rotations per second, giving an RPM range of around 1,400. This is interesting because the 12-year-old Arctic fans actually advertise a 1,350 RPM rate, so this super scientific approach here was actually kind of accurate. The same was true for my 9-year-old Corsair fan that actually came with my Corsair Carbide case, because that also span at around the advertised RPM rate of 1,200. Now, what about the Sharkoon Silent Eagle fans? These are the oldest and they run really slow at 700 RPM. So that proves that old fans will break down, right? Well, I don't personally think so. The average RPM rate was probably just below 800 RPM, and I'm actually struggling to find the original fan specs for these fans. Some sources online say that they should run at 1,200 RPMs, but other list 800 RPM, which is broadly what my tests actually show. I'm also conscious that I powered these Sharkoon fans in a hacky way. I used a 4-way splitter that then uses a 4 to 3-pin adapter, and then I connect these to a Molex fan adapter that I plug into my PSU. It's all a big fudge, and it's entirely possible that the one of these adapters actually brought the RPM rate down to 800 RPM or so. I can't be 100% sure, but what I would say is that both of these Sharkoon Silent Eagle fans actually ran at the exact same speed, and they were made in different years. So it's very unlikely that both fans were just randomly failing in the exact same way and then running at the same speed. It's much more likely that these are 800 RPM fans, or the adapters are throttling them down to that rate, which proves the 13 or 40mm case fans can actually still work absolutely fine. So that's pretty cool to know, and I'll discuss when it is actually time to change your fans in a minute. But firstly, I wanted to quickly point out that every fan is made slightly differently. There are different types of bearing systems inside them, from ball bearings to fluid dynamic bearings and every system in between. If you bought an ultra-budget fan, it might fail faster than some super highly engineered fan, for example. Now, you can take steps to maximise your fan's lifespan. Firstly, if you're constantly running your fans at 100% speed, for some reason, you might want to stop doing that. Using a fan hub or a 4-pin PWM fan will probably be better for your fan's lifespans than maxing out all the time. Secondly, some people actually take their fans apart and then keep lubricating them regularly, which will ensure that they run as efficiently as possible, and it also reduces the wear and tear, which is inevitable on the fan bearing system. To be honest though, many fans are actually quite cheap to buy. Yes, Noctua ones have a premium, for example, with the premium 120mm fans costing around £30 or $35 here in the UK. But I recently purchased 5 Arctic P12 fans and a fan hub to replace these old case fans. The fans only cost me around £5 or $6 each, so I wouldn't really bother personally taking them apart and re-lubricating them every so often, to be honest. As to why I changed these case fans and then ripped off the fins, it has nothing to do with these old fans failing or anything like that. As I've just shown, they all still spin at their advertised rates, more than a decade on, which is pretty impressive. I simply wanted a common theme for all of my fans. Previously, I had 3 different types of fans in my case, which didn't look too great, in my opinion. Since my case is black, the new Arctic fans also really blend in without any real issues. While I was there, I also switched out my old Fantix fan hub with an Arctic one. And my system is now super silent. I get full PWM control on all 5 fans, and they often run at around 1100 RPMs, which works out really quietly, and it keeps my system really cool, so that's all great. But there certainly wasn't a need to change these old case fans. They worked perfectly well until I started brutally ripping the fins off them, I guess.
Sorry.
To wrap up this video, let's answer the main question again. Is there ever a time when a fan is just too old and must be replaced? Well, no, not really. This is still working fine after 14 years. Of course, an old budget fan which runs maxed out all the time might fail after a few years, whereas a higher quality fan might still be working more than a decade on. You only really need to change your fans if they're running much slower all of a sudden, or maybe they become really noisy overnight. That's then a sign that the actual bearing is shot. Really, I think it just comes down to you'll know when it's time to change your case fans. The only other option I can think of is if you have older 3-pin fans or, God forbid, Molex fans, then you might want to change them out to 4-pin fans so you get some of the extra control of their fan speeds. Yes, I know that you can sort of control the fan speeds of 3-pin fans via the DC option that exists on some, but not all, motherboards. But in general, PWM fans are so cheap nowadays that I would just look to buy these from now on. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.